Alright, so in this chapter, Frankie has run out of the house. That's what happened in the last chapter. And in this one, he's all pissed off because, like, I was going to show those people that I'm great and everything. And they just screamed and ran away and hit me with a stick and shit. Well, you know what? I'm not going to give up. I'm going to go back and I'm going to fix this because I just did it wrong. I implemented the whole thing wrong. So he goes back to the cottage and he actually finds out that those people have decided they're just going to leave. They can't live there anymore because some horrible freak of a person came to the house and seemingly attacked them. So he gets really upset again, only now he feels betrayed. So everybody's gone from the place. Nobody lives there anymore at the moment. He takes a bunch of the stuff like the bushes and things from around the house and sets them all on fire at night and kind of dances around it, all happy that this place is burning to the ground. After the place burns to the ground, he gets up and leaves and is like, well, I guess I can't stay here anymore. Where can I go? Then he remembers Vic's journal and he reads in there that he was from Geneva. So he knows exactly where to go. He knows just about where Geneva is because Felix taught Safi geography in the house. So he knows about where Geneva is from here, but he doesn't know exactly how to get there. So he starts to decide, I can go in a southwesterly direction and I need to get to Vic. He travels for a long time. It takes him a while to get there. But one big point of this is that he can't travel during the day. Because traveling during the day means people might see him. And if people see him, then they're going to get scared. And it's going to freak him out. And it's going to freak them out. And everything's going to suck. Then he gets to a place and it's daytime. It looks nice, but he's in the middle of the deep woods, so he's like, you know what? I think I can walk during the day for once. And he starts walking, and everything feels great. Sun feels great. Everything feels wonderful again, and for the first time in a long time, he feels really happy. And then he hears voices. A little girl runs up to where he's hiding, because he heard the voices and decided to hide, and she's obviously playing with somebody. She's running away from somebody, playing with him. She runs up, and she gets a little bit too close to a river. She falls in, and Frankie jumps in to save her, pulls her out of the river, and is freaking out like she might die. And the person that was chasing her sees her lying there, unconscious, and Frankie holding her body. So the guy runs up, takes the body, he runs away with the little girl, and Frankie's chasing him down. And he actually says specifically, I have no idea why I was chasing them. The guy turns around and shoots him with a gun in the shoulder. So Frankie falls down to the ground and is just like, what? I saved this little girl. Why the fuck am I the one getting shot? What the hell happened here? So he gets really, really angry. He spends a long time finishing up his trip, only traveling at night. And he finds himself finally getting to Geneva. When he gets there, he hears a child. And this child comes up and he's like, you know what? The child probably wouldn't freak out at seeing me. Because while I'm big and scary to a bunch of adults, this kid's too young to know what deformities and everything are. So there's no way that this kid's gonna freak out when he sees me. So he walks over, grabs the kid, and the kid starts violently struggling because kids are probably more terrified of monsters than adults are. And Frankie has made a horrible mistake here. He starts telling the kid, you're never going home, you're coming with me because I can teach you how to be good and I can live with you and I won't be so damn lonely all the time. And the kid makes a huge mistake. He says, my dad is M. Frankenstein and he's gonna punish you if you kidnap me. So Frankie kills him. He strangles the kid to death. Obviously, this is the kid from chapters ago. This is the one that's Vic's little brother. Frankie sees a little thing dangling around the kid's dead body, and it's that little picture, and he picks it up, he's like, that's really a pretty lady, I like this picture, so he walks away with it, and he finds himself a barn that he can rest in. When he gets there, though, it's not empty. There's a girl sleeping in the hay. He sees her, and she's really pretty, so he goes over to her and thinks to himself, you're really pretty. That pretty face would probably hate me if it saw me, and he goes through this long process in his head of turning it from you're pretty to you'd probably hate me to I'm gonna frame you for murder because you might actually hate me if you saw me. So he takes the pendant that he has and he puts it in the folds of her dress and runs away so that she can get blamed for the crime. Frankie tells Vic, I've been alone for a long damn time. And seeing that lady's face, I know that I'm always gonna be alone. Nobody will ever love me. But you're not leaving here until you make me a wife. You're gonna make me a woman who looks like me in some way and is just as horrible and deformed as I am and can't deny herself to me. So that chapter had more action in it than any other chapter before it. God, that was a long summary. Hope you enjoyed it. Come on back for the next one. See y'all later. Bye.